so I can do this. Okay. In the right position, feet parallel, knees parallel. Okay. I'm less likely to be sued by this young man, so young man, I guess I'll ask performer, is it okay if I touch the base of the back? This dude looks stronger than me and he looks faster than me, so I don't like my chances if he doesn't like me touching without permission, right? So I want to feel the base of his back. If I feel the base of his back actually cave in, then he's cheating through this exercise. It is easy to cheat your way through this exercise, much more difficult to keep that body in a hips neutral position. Okay, knees parallel. Get that chest tall. See how tough that is? Alright, what would you do as an athlete if you're not able to do level one? You are progressing to something that's a plank. You're going to have to go. Mirror knee. Forearms, parallel. Now, I want you to imagine that I've got a drawstring and I'm pulling your umbilicus, which is your belly button. I'm pulling in your umbilicus, pulling your belly button, tightening everything up, tightening. Good. Alright, forearms parallel. Okay, now hold that. Now, if you were as close to this young man as I am, you'd actually see his core shaking right now. That's really good. His TVA is, this young man's working right now. His TVA is firing, his transverse abdominis is firing, pelvic floor muscles, deep diaphragm muscles, they are all firing. This would be a cheat, which he's not going to be doing a great job. This would be a cheat. This would be a cheat. This actually takes a little bit of effort. And it feels like you finish your explanation stress, it's incredible. You good? Alright, stay there, if you could. I won't leave you there forever, young man, just keep working. I want you to feel this. Alright, feet parallel, knees parallel. Okay, I'm going to observe, not touch here. I want your chest out tall. Okay, out moving your backs, feet off the ground 2 inches. Young man, rest. Very tough. Okay, relax, ladies. Okay. You are close to being able to do level one. Level one is done correctly if you can do it for 30 seconds with no movement. Okay, I'm not going to have to do level two, actually. I'm going to have to try level two. Level two looks like this. Tall back, knees parallel, feet off the ground, and hands come off. And hopefully these coaches can keep me honest to make sure that I'm not leaning back. Knees parallel. Don't lean back on it. Rest. Very good. Level three to progress, which is at its toughest. So I'm going to take a deep breath for this. If you're going to have an athlete go to level two, have them do 30 seconds level three. Level three increases the lever of the legs, puts more stress on the core. I'm going to actually be your sacrificial lamb right here and go through some pain for you guys to actually see this, okay? It looks like this. Feet parallel, knees parallel, chest tall. No lean back. Feet up level one. Hands up level two. Now, if you look at my toes are communicating something to you right now. As the stress is going from my deep core, all the way down my body. Now I have to lean back like this and do this for a lot longer. Feet have to be, 36 inches. Don't lean back, it's not a balancing act. You're trying to get your 4 to 5. That's actually pretty young, young lady. Okay, relax. So we've got three levels of core.